Hello and welcome everyone. I am here to discuss on ozone depletion and greenhouse effect. This module is under the paper Environmental Health in the subject of Social Medicine and Community Health. This module has been developed by a team and the team members are myself, Dr. Madhutandra Sarkar as content writer, Dr. V.M. Gupta as paper coordinator, and Dr. C.P. Mishra as principal investigator as well as content reviewer. This module has been developed with the intention that the students will be able, after completing this module, to define ozone depletion and state the causes of ozone depletion, understand the impacts or effects of ozone depletion, explain the measures to control ozone depletion, define greenhouse effect and describe the greenhouse gases. They will be able to understand the impacts of greenhouse effect and explains the measures to control greenhouse effect. What is the ozone layer? The ozone layer is a gaseous layer containing ozone molecules in the Earth's upper atmosphere called stratosphere between about 15 to 40 kilometers above the Earth's surface. This layer protects life on Earth by filtering out most of the potentially harmful short-wave ultraviolet radiation from the Sun. Beginning in the 1970s, scientific evidence showed that the ozone silt was being depleted well beyond the changes due to natural processes. The global decrease in stratospheric ozone is well correlated with the rising levels of chlorine and bromine in the stratosphere from the manufacture and release of chlorofluorocarbons and other halocarbons by human activities. The largest decreases in ozone took place in the high latitudes toward the poles, especially over Antarctica. Ozone depletion is a major environmental problem because it increases the amount of ultraviolet radiation that reaches the Earth's surface. Stopping ozone layer depletion is therefore one of the major challenges facing the world today. The Montreal Protocol, ratified in 1987, was the first of several comprehensive international agreements to protect the stratospheric ozone layer by phasing out the production and consumption of ozone-depleting substances. A greenhouse is a building made of glass that allows sunlight to enter but traps heat inside, so the building stays warm even when it is cold outside. Certain gases in the Earth's atmosphere also let in sunlight but trap heat, like the glass walls of a greenhouse. This phenomenon is called the greenhouse effect. Though the greenhouse effect works somewhat differently from an actual greenhouse, but the name has stuck anyway. The greenhouse gas molecules are responsible for the fact that the Earth enjoys temperature suitable for our active and complex biosphere. What is ozone depletion? How to define ozone depletion? Ozone depletion is gradual thinning of Earth's ozone layer in the upper atmosphere caused by the release of chemical compounds from industry and other human activities that contain gaseous chlorine and bromine. One example of ozone depletion is the annual ozone hole over Antarctica that has occurred during the Antarctic spring, that is September to November, since the early 1980s. This is not really a hole through the ozone layer, but rather a large area of the stratosphere with extremely low amounts of ozone, that is 220 Dobson units or lower. This picture shows ozone layer depletion. You can see that chlorofluorocarbons are being emitted and reach the ozone layer. They are getting broken down by ultraviolet radiation, and the chlorines are getting released, and there has been formation of the holes in the ozone layer, and the harmful ultraviolet rays are coming through the holes in the ozone layer. This picture shows the Antarctic ozone hole as seen on October 4, 2004. Here, the ozone level is very less in the stratosphere, that is 220 Dobson units. What are the causes of ozone depletion? It can be natural causes as well as the anthropogenic causes. Natural phenomena can cause temporary ozone loss. Natural phenomena such as sunspots and stratospheric winds decrease stratospheric ozone levels, but typically not by more than 1 to 2%. The major volcanic eruptions have also contributed to ozone depletion. Coming to the man-made causes, the ozone depleting substances, ODS, are mainly responsible for man-made ozone depletion. ODS are a group of manufactured chemicals containing chlorine and or bromine. These chemicals are very stable, non-toxic and environmentally safe in the lower atmosphere. However, their very stability allows them to float up intact to the stratosphere. Then they are broken apart by the intense ultraviolet light, releasing chlorine, for example chlorofluorocarbons, and bromine, for example from halons, in the stratosphere. Chlorine and bromine demolish ozone at an alarming rate by stripping an atom from the ozone molecule. The ozone depleting substances have a long lifetime, up to several centuries in the atmosphere. This picture shows different sources of ozone depleting substances. Like you can see, solvent cleaning products constitute 36.1%, refrigerator and air conditioning 29.6%, foam products constitute 14.3%, other products 12%, and sterilization process 3%. So you can see the major source of ozone depleting substances are solvent cleaning products 36.1% and refrigerator and air conditioning 29.6%. Main ozone depleting substances are chlorofluorocarbons, that is CFCs, halons, methyl chloroform, etc. Chlorofluorocarbons are the most widely used ozone depleting substances, accounting for over 80% of total stratospheric ozone depletion. They are used as coolants in refrigerators, freezers, and air conditioners, in buildings and cars. They are found in industrial solvents, dry cleaning agents, and hospital sterilants. They are also used in foam products. Halons, that is brominated fluorocarbons, also play a large role in the ozone depletion. They are used in specialized fire extinguishers. Next is methyl chloroform. This is used mainly in industry for vapor degreasing, cold cleaning, aerosols, adhesives, and chemical processing. Carbon tetrachloride. This is used in solvents and some fire extinguishers. Next is hydrochlorofluorocarbons, HCFCs. HCFCs have become major transitional substitutes for CFCs. They are much less harmful to stratospheric ozone than CFCs are, but they still cause some ozone destruction and are potent greenhouse gases. There are certain substitutes for ozone depleting substances like hydrofluorocarbons, perfluorocarbons, and sulfur hexafluoride. Hydrofluorocarbons or HFCs do not deplete the stratospheric ozone layer. However, unfortunately, they are potent greenhouse gases with long atmospheric lifetimes and high global warming potentials. The source of major emissions of these compounds is their use as refrigerants, for example, in air conditioning systems in both vehicles and buildings. Other substitutes for ozone depleting substances are perfluorocarbons and sulfur hexafluoride. What are the impacts or effects of ozone depletion? Ozone depletion has effects on human health. Like, it can cause skin cancer, both non-melanoma skin cancer and malignant melanoma. It can cause sunburns and premature aging of the skin. It can cause development of cataracts. It can cause genetic damage as well as immunosuppression. Ozone depletion has also adverse effects on plants. They can affect plant growth, thus reducing agricultural productivity. Ozone depletion has also adverse effects on marine ecosystems. They can threaten growth and survival of the tiny creatures, for example, phytoplankton, that provide the original food source for the rest of the marine food chain. Ozone depletion has also effects on animals. They may cause eye and skin cancers in domestic animals, similar to those observed in humans. Ozone depletion has also effects on biogeochemical cycles. It can affect terrestrial and aquatic biogeochemical cycles, thus altering both sources and sinks of greenhouse and chemically important trace gases. Trace gases are those gases that make up only 1% by volume of Earth's atmosphere. And one of the trace gases is argon. Ozone depletion has also effects on materials. They can affect synthetic polymers like plastic, rubber, naturally occurring biopolymers like wood, fabrics, which have also socio-economic implications. Next, what are the measures to control ozone depletion? There are certain measures to help protect the ozone layer at the individual level and also the international effort. What are the measures to help protect the ozone layer at the individual level? Make sure that old refrigerators and air conditioners are disposed of safely by giving them to a recycling yard. Take care not to damage the cooling circuit which contains the ODS. Ensure technicians repairing refrigerator or air conditioner recover and recycle the old ODS so they are not released into the atmosphere. Conduct regular inspection and maintenance of air conditioning and refrigeration appliances to prevent and minimize refrigerant leakage. Buy air conditioning and refrigeration equipment that do not use HCFCs as refrigerant. Buy aerosol products that do not use HCFCs or CFCs as propellants. When motor vehicle air conditioners need servicing, make sure that the refrigerants are properly recovered and recycled instead of being vented to the atmosphere. When renovating house, make sure that old insulation foams containing ODS are disposed of as environmentally hazardous waste. Plant trees. Increase awareness of the problem and initiate local action. Next is international effort. In September 1987, an international treaty aimed at saving the Earth's ozone layer, known as the Montreal Protocol on Substances that Deplete the Ozone Layer, was signed in Montreal, Canada. The protocol requires the phasing out of the ODAs in accordance with agreed schedules. The atmospheric levels of nearly all the ODAs have declined substantially in the past 2 decades. Next, we will look at greenhouse effect. What is greenhouse effect? The greenhouse effect is a natural process that warms the Earth's surface. The sun powers the Earth's climate, radiating energy at very short wavelengths, predominantly in the visible or near visible, for example, ultraviolet part of the spectrum. Roughly 1/3 of the solar energy that reaches the top of the Earth's atmosphere is reflected directly back to space. The remaining 2/3 is absorbed by the surface and to a lesser extent by the atmosphere. To balance the absorbed incoming energy, the Earth must, on average, radiate the same amount of energy back to space. Because the Earth is much colder than the Sun, it radiates at much longer wavelengths, primarily in the infrared part of the spectrum. Much of this thermal radiation emitted by the land and ocean is absorbed by the atmosphere, including clouds, and re-radiated back to the Earth. The atmosphere surrounding the Earth contains the greenhouse gases and acts like a blanket, trapping more heat and turning the Earth into a greenhouse. This is called the greenhouse effect. If there were no greenhouse effect, the Earth's average surface temperature would be a very chilly minus 18 degrees Celsius, that is 0 degree Fahrenheit, instead of the comfortable 15 degrees Celsius, that is 59 degrees Fahrenheit, that it is today. The greenhouse effect is somewhat similar to the process that goes on in a real greenhouse. The glass walls in a greenhouse reduce airflow and increase the temperature of the air inside. Analogously, but through a different physical process, the Earth's greenhouse effect warms the surface of the planet. The natural greenhouse effect, however, is beneficial for life on Earth. What is enhanced greenhouse effect? Human activities, particularly the burning of fossil fuels, that is coal, oil, and natural gas, and clearing of forest, are increasing the concentrations of greenhouse gases and thus are greatly intensifying the natural greenhouse effect, causing global warming. This is called the enhanced greenhouse effect. This picture shows greenhouse effect. In the first step, solar radiation is coming and some portion of it is getting reflected from the atmosphere. In the second step, the rest of the sun's energy is absorbed by the land and the oceans, heating the Earth. In the third step, heat radiates from the Earth towards the space. In the fourth step, some of this heat is trapped by greenhouse gases in the atmosphere, keeping the Earth warm enough to sustain life. So this is the natural greenhouse effect. However, in the step 5, you can see that human activities such as burning fossil fuels, agriculture, and land clearing are increasing the amount of greenhouse gases which are released into the atmosphere. This is trapping extra heat and causing the increase in the temperature. So this is the enhanced greenhouse effect. In this context, you should know what is a greenhouse and how it works. A greenhouse is a house where the walls and roof are made of glass. And an important property of glass is that, you know, it transmits infrared radiation of very short wavelength coming from extremely hot bodies like the sun, while it reflects infrared radiations of long wavelengths emitted by less hot objects like those inside a greenhouse. This property of glass is used to keep the plants warm and safe in a greenhouse during the winter. The glass of a greenhouse allows the visible light and infrared radiations of short wavelength to pass through. The radiations from the sun are therefore able to penetrate the glass and enter into the greenhouse. These radiations are then absorbed by the plants and other objects inside the greenhouse. As a result, they become warm. The warm objects emit infrared radiations of longer wavelengths. These longer wavelength radiations are reflected by the glass and are retained inside. The heat remains inside the greenhouse and keeps it warm. This picture shows a greenhouse. What are the greenhouse gases? And what are their properties? The gases that trap heat in the atmosphere are called the greenhouse gases. They have the property of absorbing infrared radiation, that is net heat energy, emitted from the Earth's surface and re-radiating it back to the Earth's surface, thus contributing to the greenhouse effect. Human activities, especially combustion of fossil fuels since the Industrial Revolution, are responsible for steady increases in atmospheric concentrations of various greenhouse gases. The greenhouse gases include carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, fluorinated gases, surface level ozone, water vapor. Among these, carbon dioxide is the most significant greenhouse gas. Next comes the methane, which is the second most important. And water vapor is the most potent greenhouse gas. Carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, ozone, and water vapor are naturally present in the atmosphere. Whereas the fluorinated gases owe their existence almost entirely to industrial sources. And the fluorinated gases include hydrofluorocarbons, HFCs, perfluorocarbons, PFCs, sulfur hexafluoride, and nitrogen trifluoride. Another greenhouse gas is surface or low-level ozone, which is a result of air pollution. It must be distinguished from naturally occurring stratospheric ozone, because stratospheric ozone has a very different role in the planetary radiation balance. The behavior of water vapor is fundamentally different from that of the other greenhouse gases. What are the impacts of greenhouse effect? Greenhouse effect can cause global warming. The main cause of the current global warming trend is the enhanced greenhouse effect. That is, warming that results when the atmosphere traps heat radiating from the Earth towards space. Global warming is the main effect of increases in atmospheric greenhouse gas concentrations. It could have disastrous consequences. Second is albedo effect. What is albedo? Albedo is the ratio of the outgoing solar radiation reflected by an object to the incoming solar radiation incident upon it. Sometimes the impacts of the greenhouse effect are stated in terms of the albedo of the Earth, the overall average reflection coefficient. This affects the equilibrium temperature of the Earth. The greenhouse effect by trapping infrared radiation can lower the albedo of the Earth and cause global warming. Coming to the measures to reduce greenhouse effect, the following are the measures which can reduce greenhouse gas emissions. Reduce, reuse, and recycle. you must be heard of these words. It helps conserve energy and reduces pollution and greenhouse gas emissions from resource extraction, manufacturing and disposal. Secondly, use water efficiently. It takes lots of energy to pump, treat and heat water. Saving water reduces greenhouse gas emissions. Use energy efficient light bulbs at home. Use energy efficient products and appliances. Save energy and reduce greenhouse gas emissions by setting computer, monitor, and any other equipment to power down when not in use. Use green power. What is green power? This is environmentally friendly electricity generated from renewable energy sources such as wind and the sun. Switching to public transportation will be helpful. Carpooling, biking, or telecommuting can save energy and reduce greenhouse gas emissions. Purchase a fuel-efficient, low greenhouse gas vehicle, drive smart, and maintain car regularly. To summarize, ozone depletion is a major environmental problem because it increases the amount of ultraviolet radiation that reaches the Earth's surface. It is caused by the release of certain chemical compounds containing gaseous chlorine and or bromine from industry and other human activities. These chemicals are called ozone depleting substances or ODS. The impacts of ozone depletion include increasing the rate of skin cancer, eye cataracts, and genetic and immune system damage. It can cause damage to crops, harm to marine life. It can affect certain materials such as plastic, rubber, wood. Apart from the efforts at the individual level, the international effort is also necessary to save the Earth's ozone layer. The Montreal Protocol on substances that deplete the ozone layer is a successful international effort in this regard. The greenhouse effect is a natural process that warms the Earth's surface. The natural greenhouse effect is beneficial. However, human activities, particularly the burning of fossil fuels, that is coal, oil, and natural gas, and clearing of forest, are increasing the concentrations of greenhouse gases and thus are greatly intensifying the natural greenhouse effect, causing global warming. This is the enhanced greenhouse effect, which is the main cause of global warming. The greenhouse gas emissions, however, can be reduced by following certain simple steps like reduce, reuse and recycle, use of energy-efficient light bulbs, other energy-efficient products and appliances, and use of public transportation, etc. Has adverse effects on health. It can cause health-related deaths due to increased intensity and frequency of heat waves. Global warming can cause allergy and asthma due to increase in smog pollution. It can cause outbreaks of infectious diseases, food and waterborne diseases. Like global warming can cause increase incidence of, and outbreaks of malaria, dengue fever, diarrheal illnesses and foodborne illnesses like salmonella. Increase in malnutrition due to increase in intensity and frequency of droughts. Global warming has adverse impacts on environment also. It can cause change in weather. There will be increased intensity and frequency of droughts, floods, and heat waves. It can cause rise in sea levels, which cause coastal erosion and increase the risk of coastal floods. Also, melting of ice caps and glaciers can cause further increase in sea levels. Global warming also can cause change in ecosystem. It can cause change in the growing season, change in the timing of flower blooms. There is increased risk of crop failure. Global warming also has socio-economic impacts due to increased intensity and frequency of adverse environmental effects like droughts, floods, and heat waves. It can cause increased losses to property and life. It can reduce the availability and affordability of insurance. It can cause costly disruptions to society, and the worst affected populations due to global warming are those living in low-lying coastal areas and residents of poorer countries who do not have the resources to adapt to changes in temperature extremes and water resources. Thanks for visiting EPG Pathshala and listening to this module.